When things move more than what is desired, it is called mode of transportation. Now I'll tell you both the manufacturing side and the governance side, both comparative study. Okay? In a plant, because most of you are from manufacturing here, who have come to understand what is lean in governance. So I'll address both. In manufacturing, material travels all over the world inside the plant before it exits. Okay? So it is inside the plant for a higher period of time. And that is why plants don't make money. It is as simple as that. Similarly, when a patient goes or a ship comes and it has to travel more, if there were no expressways from Ahmedabad to Delhi, you would have to take a longer route. You would still reach there anyway, but you are incurring more waste. So flow has to be perfect. Any organization, whether it is governance side or the manufacturing side, if the flow is not matched, forget it. Simple. Just forget. You cannot be successful, profitable, or a developed country if your flow is not right. This is what China did 15 years ago, create flow. If you go to China now, if we have to travel around 1,000 kilometers in India on an expressway, it may take us 7 to 8 hours. But in China, you can do it flat in 3 hours. So the deliveries are faster from China. So the first thing, mode of transportation, that means waste of transportation, has to be identified, reduced and eliminated if you want to be good, you want to be lean. And lean does not mean patla. It means to be fit, to be flexible. Okay? So the first waste is addressed like that. Second is mode of wading. I took examples. Ship wading at the dock. So it's burning fuel. It is wasting its time because if it does not travel, it is not going to make money. The ship charges you for the distance it travels and it takes your goods. If I have to go to the railway station to book a ticket, I incur waste of transportation. So I can sit on my computer and at my own convenience I can do it. But somebody wants to go there, it's fine. But I have options available to me. Clear? Second one, the mode of motion. Stirling Hospital, or example, a private hospital and a government hospital. Government hospital, patients need to move from one point to the other to get them tested or whatever, do some tests and do some reports and whatever it is, X, Y, Z. So the patient is moving. If you go to private hospitals, you are on the bed and everything comes onto the bed. That is why they charge you heavy, because they don't give you that pain. So they have eliminated the mudha of the motion, the waste of the motion by a person or a patient in that, and they charge you, and they charge you at a certain fee. Choice is yours. Whether you want to be in the comfort zone or you want to be in the other zone. Same way. Now I took the example of the ticket booking or going to the bank. Now I go to an ATM which is near my house. So I save onto my mudha of motion, waste of motion. I can still go to the bank. Now if you go to the banks, some of the banks don't even count the money. They tell you count it, put it in an envelope, seal it and put it there, we will call you back. They don't even count. If you want your money to be picked up from your residence, they are ready to do it because they don't want you to do mudha of motion. Why? Why? They are not my friends. They are not my friends. Why they don't want? Now see the other side as well. Yes. Why? Expenses. Which sort of expenses? Maintaining a branch. You need a bigger branch if more people come in. You need better facilities, you need better people, you need more people to manage. Now you have CM online in India, in Gujarat. You don't need to go to Sachivalay. You just log on to CM online, register your complaint, 24 hours they call you. What is the problem? Sachivalay does not have space for 10,000 people. So they are reducing the muda of motion. Okay? Muda of waiting. Waiting can be seen everywhere. It can be seen everywhere. Initially, 10 years ago, the flight used to come at Ahmedabad airport. There used to be cool 3 hours before it used to take off again. Now if you go, the turnaround time the aircraft lands and takes off is not more than 50 minutes. They have a target. Pardon? 45 minutes, he says, because I estimated 45-50 minutes. They have their own targets. You're waiting for baggage. 10 years ago, you would wait for 45 minutes. Now the baggage comes in before you reach the belt. So they are trying to eliminate the muda of waiting. Muda of rejection. Now everything is going online, so there are hardly some errors in the documentation, etc. So rejections are taken care of. It's a standard rejection, so there is no discrepancy in the paperwork and stuff like that. Now I hear that because of this thing, land becoming expensive, and one land being sold to so many people, now the government is coming out with a scheme where you can trade land online on the computers, like a stock, electronically traded land. So there is no muda of duplication, one land being sold to many people. Overprocessing, muda of overprocessing. Too many people getting involved, because one of you said here, to maximum utilization of the resources, it is always better to reduce your resources. Don't utilize them. I am married. I can't ask my wife to keep on cooking for 24 hours. He is not married, so he does not want to listen. Anyway, once upon a time I got married, one day you will get married, so not a problem. Okay, fine. It does not mean you have a resource you keep on utilizing. The more the utilization of the resource, the more problems you create. You have to only go by what is needed, what is in demand. What is in demand? Inventory, muda of inventory, another one. Manufacturing, we keep stocks. And we feel satisfied. Ghanu material che, you know. We can deliver on time. I bet you will never be able to deliver on time. I bet on this, you will never be able to deliver on time. Because there is so much of fat. There is so much of fat in an organization that it really becomes difficult to get fit. More inventory, more space. More space, more people, more the problems. Just go by what is in demand. Now let us see from a different viewpoint. We have a ration card. We have an election card. We have a PAN card. Okay? We got a passport. We got so many cards, you know. Where do you see the muda? They are so beautiful. You carry, you pay, and you show your identity, and you walk through, or you use your credit cards, and then you get what you want to buy. But I see a lot of muda. I see too much of muda in this. Overproduction. It is all duplication of work. Why can't I have a single card which is my ration card, which is my passport, which is my everything? that is the one which is coming out now. Now you understand why the government is working on those issues. There are mudas, absolute mudas. Now, when a child turns 18, he has to go and stand in a queue at the RTO to get his license. Then he has to submit his this photocopy, that photocopy, duly notarized. If he has that card, he goes there, he just asks somebody to take his test and his license should be punched in that only period. Absolutely lean, just getting lean. Yes, somebody had a question. Yes. One day I may lose my wife, does not mean I will have two wives. If you can't take care of her, don't get married. You get what I'm saying? I say it in a harsh way, but you should get my message. If you can't take care of it, don't ever get it. You completed your engineering or MBA, whatever. Do you have one degree or two degrees? One certificate or two? You answer my question, what I'm asking. You have one or two? Which one? Two engineering certificates? Suppose you lose it? Change your mindset. Change your mindset. Why? Sometimes I really wonder why the kids have to go and submit their date of birth and this, where were you born, what is your father's name and mother's name? Stupid. Absolutely stupid. Why do I need to go to the airport, wait in a queue, get my passport stamped that I'm exiting the airport? I just swipe my card and I go out. Yes or no?
Yes.
If the thing is not working, the gate should not open. Simple, I should come back. On a toll tax, I see six people standing collecting 5 rupees from me. Stupid. What are they doing? Now if I go to the airport, they have got a new system where you get the, you press the thing and you get a car ticket. So when you come back, you again put the ticket and they decide how much to pay. It is automatic. Still there is one guy standing pressing for you. All muda. Labor is cheaper in India. I am sorry, it was cheaper in India, not anymore. Huh? Huh? Why? Because we do muda, not them. We do muda, you know, understand. Don't point finger at them. So many interesting things come up. So many interesting things. Okay. Yes?
Sir, as you right now just say that if you are not ready for a particular thing, then you should not go for it. Do our government is ready for such kind of advanced systems, or they have, you know, specific priorities to fulfill before they go for such kind of things?
The government is always ready. We are not disciplined. We are not disciplined. Expressways have come up, new ports are coming up, good airports are coming up for your, you have BRTS, some stupid people also drive on the BRTS once in a while. Fantastic thing they have made here. It is becoming a world heritage. Why are we spoiling it? Forget that people spit, thukte hain pankha ke sabhi jage, yes or no? Why do we blame the government? The government wants to go lean. Gujarat is much more leaner than any other state today. But still we are not as compared to the European and the US and those. But yes, we are being recognized today as the front runners. A few days ago, there was an article in Times of India that Ahmedabad is the best city to live in. Why? Why should we blame them? What they are not doing, they are doing everything for us. The fantastic road structure in Ahmedabad, if you see, 4 bridges, 5 bridges to cross, okay? Then there are ring roads and there is 132 feet, it's all a matrix structure, you can crisscross in 30 minutes. One point to the other, east, west, north, south. Where will you get this? Why it is done? Designing by School of Architecture and SEPT and all, why it is being done? Flow. Fundamental thing is flow. Flow has to be fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. बोलना था ना नहीं चलता रिकॉर्ड ही नहीं होता एनीवे आई जस्ट वांटेड टू चेक वेदर यू ऑल आर अवेक और नॉट या एनी क्वेश्चंस यस ओके सम एक्सपेंसेस आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड यू मीन टू से इफ सरदार पटेल द रेस्ट 95 आर यूजफुल इफ 5% ऑफ द एक्सपेंडिचर इज नॉट यूजफुल लेट्स फॉरगेट इट लेट्स कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन द 90% विच द गवर्नमेंट इज डूइंग लेट्स नॉट गेट इनटू पॉलिटिक्स लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द 90% और एटलीस्ट 50% व्हाट दे आर डूइंग आई वुड नॉट लाइक टू कमेंट ऑन दैट Now, let me share some practical examples with you. In an underdeveloped country like Tanzania, if you want electricity for your house, you don't get a bill. Too much muda, no? Somebody comes and checks your meter, okay? Then he goes back, then he prepares the bill is mailed, either you pay in cash, or you go and pay a check, you have to go to the nearest point where the bill can be collected. They have simple systems. You get a card. With the meter, you get a card, something like an ATM card or a prepaid card. You go to some points which are nearby, get it recharged, put it in your electricity meter. It will only work up to the point till you have money. Simple. Underdeveloped. They are so underdeveloped, but see the systems they have.